dust. Another one bites the dust. And another one gone. And another one gone. Another one bites the dust. Hey everybody, John Van Dyke here for New Jersey Exposed. Today is Saturday, July 24th, 2021. Time is 3:11 p.m. Jersey time. All right, so we got a couple stories here that I'm actually doing. I failed to mention this in the previous video. These are stories. I've been doing a lot of stories of cops getting caught and arrested, so we found some stories of cops being heroes, well-trained, I might add, heroes being sentenced. Because I've had people ask me, well, what happened to this cop? What happened to that cop? What happened with that story? Now, this is not a particular story that I did, but these are stories that have to do with the Blue Zero Heroes. You know, those well-trained, say it, people, follow after me. Well-trained, dedicated, professional hero out, always out risking our lives as he protects and serves the government. And this one is reported in the Daily News. It's dated July 13th and reads as follows. Florida cops sentenced to 12 years in prison for planting drugs. Wow, now that's a shocker. An officer planting evidence. I gotta tell you, we haven't heard too many of those stories. But those stories are out there. An officer getting sentenced for planting drugs on people. Here's the story right there. Now, I want everybody to keep an open mind because obviously this is an isolated incident and it doesn't represent all the other bad cops out there. The other bad Blue Zero heroes are out there risking our lives and doing shit they shouldn't be doing. All right, let's find out what this one was up to. A former Florida cop was sentenced Tuesday to 12 years and 6 months in prison for planting drugs at three traffic stops. Zachary Wester, 28, was convicted in May on 19 charges related to three incidents that occurred while he worked for the Jackson County Sheriff's Office from 2016 to 2018. Wester was fired amid the investigation, and prosecutors in the Panhandle County dropped 119 cases he was involved. Imagine that. He was responsible for 119 cases being dropped. And here is his face. There he is. Take a good look at that hero, that wonderful, that well-trained, dedicated, professional hero. Take a good look at him. Oh, yeah, he's an honest person. I'm sure the bootleggers get their nut off to him every night, hearing about all the great things he was doing in the community. I wonder how many awards he got. All right, let's read the story. Wester was convicted in the cases of Teresa Odom, Joshua Emmanuel, and Stephen Van. During Odom's arrest, Wester was seen on body cam footage carrying a baggie to her truck. Once again, the camera's involved. You've got to wonder, when the defendant was making these stops, lead state attorney Tom Whelan said at trial, is it going through his head? Is anybody going to believe this person over me? Well, of course not. We know how that goes. Fortunately, there's cameras involved now. Prosecutors had asked for 15-year sentence, the Tallahassee Democrat reports. Wester was convicted of one count of racketeering, three counts of official misconduct, three counts of perjury, three counts of fabricating evidence, four counts of possession of a controlled substance, three counts of possession of drug paraphernalia, and two counts of false imprisonment. The sentences for those crimes would not usually merit such a lengthy sentence, but prosecutors argue Wester's case was a special circumstance, according to the Democrat. Yeah, special. He's a cop. He should be held to a higher level. With that great power comes great responsibility. Williams said Tuesday at the sentence hearing, the defendant made choices to violate that trust and committed crimes against those people he was sworn to protect. Stop with the sworn to protect. They're not protecting anybody. They're protecting the government. See, once again, even the prosecutors can't even. They got to perpetrate this cop again of bullshit. Look at it. I'll put it right up there so you can see that. Look at that. It's such bullshit. Let me read this again. With that great power comes great responsibility. Williams said Tuesday at the sentence hearing, the defendant made choices to violate that trust and committed crimes against those people he was sworn to protect.
Check the mic and make sure it sound right, boys.
Well, there you go. Another Blue Zero hero off the prison. Care to chime in, bootlickers? I love to hear what you say, bootlickers. John Van Dyke. I'll put the link in the description. You can read the story yourself. Till next time, people.
It sound right, boys.